A million dead fish at Menindee, fierce bushfires ripping through scorched land. There's no denying the current drought is slowing and savaging economies in regional New South Wales. As we go to air tonight, the entire state cabinet is driving from Dubbo to Bourke, a special mission for the Deputy Premier to show his colleagues just how dire the situation is.
Touchdown in dry, dusty Dubbo, where dams are just puddles, cows have no grass to graze on, and when a trail of polished boots hit the pavement, you can tell city ministers are in town.
No suits, no ties, jeans and chinos.
The change of scenery and eye-opener as ministers boarded a bus bound for Bourke, taking in the barren land on the way, while the Premier and her deputy travelled in secure cars.
It's always great to be here. I've been here lots of times and it's great to be here again with the whole team.
Another important part of this trip is to inject some cash into the local communities that have been stretched by the drought. One way to do that is shouting a local a beer at the watering hole.
That and picking up a few Christmas presents to support the Buy From The Bush campaign.
It's been amazing. My business was so quiet to literally it was live and all happening. I've never posted so many parcels.
While Dubbo is struggling under level 4 water restrictions, ministers will tomorrow tour Bourke, a town listed at high risk of running dry. Today, the government announced an extra $15 million will be spent trucking water into regional towns to stop that happening. They breed them tough in the bush, but some of these ministers are in for a shock.
It's dry, dusty, the drought's biting. The landscape looks like, you know, it almost looks like a bushfire's gone through.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.